It's time for the weekly No Pain, No Gain market update with a team at Payne Capital Management here in New York City.
Good morning. This is Bob Payne, Chief Investment Officer here at Payne Capital Management. And despite the weakness at the beginning of February, the month of January had been nothing short of outstanding for the stock market. The S&P 500 gained 7.5%, and emerging markets are up already double digits in January, which is basically the kind of return many investors expect, not just for a month, but for an entire year. Now, for the market, history is on the side of the bulls. You know, the old expression, as goes January, so goes the year. Strong Januaries typically lead to a strong year, and this has been the fifth best January since 1950 for the S&P 500. Now, the nine other starts to the year like that have resulted in further gains of 12.3% on average, though there was definitely more volatility, you know, in the average year having a 5 or 10% correction. You see, this market last year didn't even have one 5% correction, not normal. And the chances of having two consecutive years of up markets without a 5% correction, well, it's never happened before in history. So that supports our view that we're almost certainly going to see more of downside volatility this year. But you couple the fact that the first 5 days of January were up 2.77%, and any time in history where the first 5 days are up over 2%, we have a 91% chance of the year being higher. You couple that with the January effect, and we think even though with more volatility, the end of the year in 2018, the markets will be higher. So what should you do? Well, I suggest that you put on your seatbelt, strap on your helmet, focus on your goals, ignore the noise, and use the impending volatility to your advantage.